the leaders of leaders. Okay? I've met them all. So I say to you, sir, COB, we are lucky to have you, and thank you very much.
Scientology award ceremony there, we're told. We are looking at the Church of Scientology up close tonight. One of the most controversial aspects of the church is their view on mental health counseling, psychiatry, psychology. Tom Cruise has linked the science of psychology with crimes against humanity. And then, of course, there was his famous criticism of Brooke Shields over the effectiveness of medication in treating postpartum depression. Now, some of what Mr. Cruise has said about psychiatry and medication is simply not true. To better understand his argument, however, on an earlier program, I spoke with Scientologist Bruce Wiseman, president of an organization called the Citizens Commission on Human Rights, that says they investigate what they call psychiatric abuses.
The problem with psychiatry today is that it's a fraud. Psychiatry pretends to be a science when in fact it is not.
The same criticism is leveled against Scientology that it's all based on pseudoscience and that it's a fraud.
Scientology is a religion. It deals with the spirit of man. Psychiatry is a materialistic practice that pretends to be a science.
You don't believe it has helped anybody?
How can it help someone? You talked about the antidepressant drugs, Anderson. Studies at Harvard, studies at Yale, studies at Columbia, studies at the State University of New York tie these drugs to acts of suicide and or violence, yet the psychiatrist slaps a label on a child who looks out the window or butts into line and puts them on these mind-altering drugs.
Just factually speaking, though, the actual number of suicides or side effects is actually quite small compared to the number of people who say that they derive very real life-saving benefits from these drugs.
Factually speaking, studies show that people on these antidepressant drugs commit suicide almost twice as much as those who don't.
There's no clear necessarily correlation between the drugs themselves. You can make the argument these are people who are, you know, have real problems and maybe would have committed suicide anyway, and perhaps the drugs didn't help them. But you're just saying categorically no drugs work.
No, and it's important to understand the difference when you say the word drugs. We're talking about mind-altering drugs. We're not talking about medicines that actually help, insulin or antibiotics.
What you have been talking about is drugs, and what Tom Cruise keeps talking about is drugs and electroshock therapy. He makes it sound as if anyone who goes to a psychiatrist gets pumped full of drugs and suddenly gets electroshock therapy against their will. That's misleading. I mean, the number of people who actually get electroshock therapy, electroconvulsive therapy, is tiny compared to the number of people who enter into talk therapy. Are you opposed to talk therapy as well from psychiatrists?
100,000 people a year get electroshocked, Anderson.
Right, and 10 million people get antidepressant medication. Relatively speaking, it's a tiny number given the number of people who actually are in therapeutic situations. Are you opposed to talk therapy?
I'm opposed to any psychiatric practice that pretends to be a science and it's not. Let me go back to the instance of shock treatment. A five-year-old knows not to put his finger in a light socket, yet a psychiatrist will run hundreds of volts of electricity through someone's brain and pretend that it's therapy. This is barbaric. It's actually barbaric that this practice continues.
Okay, you're opposed to... not every psychiatrist pumps you full of medication. The idea is, and the standards of care are, that you're supposed to enter into a discussion, a dialogue, you're supposed to enter into talk therapy, and medication is usually considered a last resort in the ideal. What is the difference between the classes which Scientology offers, which seems to me a very expensive form of therapy, and going into a therapist's office and talking about your early life, your early emotional issues, the same things which Scientology seems to address?
Scientology addresses the spirit. Psychiatry damages the brain. These drugs are brain damaging. Shock treatment
is brain damaging. With all due respect, that's a slogan. Let's get away from bumper sticker slogans and let's actually talk. What is wrong with talk therapy?
It's the truth.
So is any form of counseling other than with a Scientologist or a Scientology approved group inappropriate?
Communication is a universal solvent. Pretending that someone has got some kind of chemical imbalance, that's the falsehood. There is no chemical imbalance.
Okay, but if communication is universal solvent, then it's okay to go to a psychiatrist and communicate and talk about experiences, cognitive therapy. That's okay?
But the psychiatrist pretends that there's a chemical imbalance and they're going to treat this with drugs or with shock.
Not true, sir. I mean, not all psychiatrists pump you full of medication. I mean, that's just simply not true. There are plenty of people who are with psychiatrists who don't receive medication who are in talk therapy. And you're, but I'm just want to, I just want to make sure we're accurate. You're saying that's still wrong because this person is a fraud, basically.
I'm saying that they're pretending to be a science when they're not, that they're a pseudoscience, that they're whatever treatment they're using is based on a falsehood. It's based on a lie. It's based on a pretense that there's some underlying chemical basis, that there's a medical problem, when in fact there is not. And I think the public has been misinformed. Teachers have been misinformed. Mm-hmm. About the subjective nature of psychiatric diagnosis and the violence-inducing nature of the drugs used to treat them. I think it's criminal, frankly.
Again, we're really just looking for facts, not opinion. We're not out to get anybody. We should note we did speak with the church leaders today about speaking with us again tonight. They declined. They are always invited.